Wow.
O sea, not on Jaws. Steven Spielberg. A reference point in cinema. I remember when I saw it, and then reading about it in probably the best book I know on cinema. And that is Adventures in the Screen Trade, William Goldman. Marvelous stories about Dustin Hoffman, what he did on the set of Marathon Man, Robert Redford, and again, the misdemeanor, misbehavior after the launching of Butch Cassidy and Sundance Kid, and during the making of All the President's Men. Bogart was a whiner. Perhaps Clint Eastwood doesn't like horses. Interaction with Warren Beatty, Richard Attenborough, Laurence Olivier. The old film d'auteur, the author film, Goldman is against this notion. There's a whole team behind. And then the director, even if he's producing it, it's not, the key is not the only one. And then on Hitchcock, he has an interesting take. After Hitchcock was so praised that he's the man making those movies, he's the one. He started making films that weren't that great, but anyway, returning on Jaws, it's in that context, he's using this example and others, and pointing out how important the special effects, which were not that developed when Jaws was made, of course. How important the special effect man was for Jaws, for creating the monster, the shark, the huge shark, mentioned in the title, Jaws, the Jaws Arcades. And so it's not just Steven Spielberg. Then the finding of the story and is also in the book, but you should read the book, exceptional. So, Jaws I've seen in Predap. I remember back in the communist days, we didn't have access to films. What am I saying? Television was on for 2 hours. What was it? 8 to 10, and it was just Ceausescu. Coach Ceausescu, his magic, his power, his intelligence, his wife, and all the bullshit. North Korean TV, if you know what I mean. Films, no, but in some underground places, the students' dormitory, someone had a video and some films, and then they would charge, and it was like a small illegal cinema. And in other places, odd places, like here at the Horizon Hotel. I thought something was wrong. In Predel, they had Jaws and others, but Jaws I remember was incredible, because it's indeed a masterpiece in many ways. It's not, I mean, in mainly probably in the sense that without such a big story, it's so wonderfully crafted that it keeps the audience awed and thrilled. Even if what it's all about, Jaws, a shark, a big shark, yes, is killing a girl at the beginning, and the way they do it, he's fabulous, he's a genius and one of the best, of course, in the trade. The way this girl gets killed and they're filming that is amazing. But that's the story. They kill this girl, and then there's this major threat to this place near the beach. No visitors will come, they have to catch him. Some guy, a tough guy, gets involved, and he is a character, he's well. This Roy Steiger, Richard Dreyfuss in the film. But the making of it is amazing. Otherwise, what, as I said, the story is basically a shark is up there killing people. Yes, that happens. It's been in the news. I was reading in The Economist about the third, fourth shark attack in Australia this year. And how concerned they are. But still, as they say about this, terrorist attacks and other incidents that get the headlines, but they're not really so deadly, statistically speaking. Chances are, there are more chances that you get killed by sleeping on a bathroom floor in your home than being killed by a shark or in a terrorist attack. So, yeah, but splendid film, nevertheless. Or, especially considering what it made from the subject.